All right, great. I'm so ready. I've been looking forward to this all day because I finally saw a really freaking good 2024 movie. It has been a shit season, you know? It's been one shit after another shit, the diversity, the tapestry of shit, whatever. This is just a good movie. And I was not expecting it to be quite as good as it was. It has been in theaters the last few weeks. I kind of reluctantly went to see it because, I don't know, I was a little bored. The movie is called In a Violent Nature. And I'm not sure if you guys have heard of it. But it is,
I was going to go see it.
It is, according to IMDb, a Canadian slasher movie, which, I mean, come on, who doesn't want to go see that? The director is a first-time director named Chris Nash. I don't know if he's related to John or not, but this is not a movie about hallucinations. It is described as an ambient slasher movie. That's according to Wikipedia, but it's really just a freaking awesome movie. I don't want to say too much about the plot, because it, one of the joys of the movie is kind of figuring out what it is about, and you don't quite know what it's about for a while, but it is a slasher movie. It's set in the wilderness in Ontario, and there are these various groups of travelers and people that are just hanging out in the forest, you know, getting high, drinking beer, maybe having sex. There's a little bit of like a Wes Craven-ness to it. But what's cool about the movie, without giving too much away, is you see the killer right away. And the movie kind of is more from the killer's perspective than the victim's perspective. So it's not the killer, you know, he's kind of in the Jason Voorhees, Freddy Krueger sort of vein. But you already know who the killer is. There are some spectacular kills in this movie. I mean, my God, when the Talk to Me movie came out last year and everyone was like, oh, this is the most gross and extreme movie you'll ever see. And it was like nothing. I mean, I fell asleep during that shit. This movie has some legit kills. All right. It goes to work on this shit. Even Tarantino would probably appreciate it. It's a reminder that gruesome kills are fun in movies when you're in the right frame of mind. And it's just well made. I mean, there's nothing corny about it. Like, the special effects are all practical. They're really well done. There's not a lot of talking in the movie. There's a plot and there is some dialogue. Actually, there's a couple scenes where there's a lot of dialogue, but for the most part, it's a very sparse movie. And again, you just kind of follow this serial killer, this slasher, who never really speaks in the movie too much. He does some surprising things. There's a really surprising moment with a toy car in this movie that kind of reminded me of like James Whale, almost Frankenstein-like. But it's just an awesome movie. I was really, really impressed by this director and the cast. And I really didn't know where this movie was going. It is just a bloody delight. See it at 11 p.m. See it at a midnight showing if you can. I think this movie has to be seen in the theater. I know it's been acquired or distributed by Shudder, and so it might come to the Shudder Network at some point. But this is a movie that is meant to be seen in the theater. It's not necessarily like, you know, you're going to just scream at it because it's so fun to watch. But like, there's shit in this movie that I can't believe that this director did. It's like, oh, shit, the camera's going to linger on this for the next 8 minutes. Oh, my God. And it's really well done. It's a great movie. I was very surprised, pleasantly surprised by it. This is a solid 3.5-star movie. I think it rises above the level of Smile and Barbarian. But it's a reminder that, you know, it doesn't have to be Terrifier 2 just to be a good movie with gruesome violence. And again, horror movies are great. They're great because they can be low budget. You don't need a big cast. You need someone who's passionate about movies. And it's like Tarantino quoting Melville, you don't have to know how to make movies to be a great filmmaker. You just have to love movies. And I think this filmmaker loves movies. And this is a really, really solid movie. I was very, very impressed.
Nice.
I'm also
Go see that on Friday, but I got stuck at work and I couldn't actually get to see it. So
I'm stuck on the buzz of it. Like, I'm, you know, it's like having a Sierra Nevada Pale Ale. You get that buzz, you know, or that runner's high because you guys are runners now. I'm still on a runner's high of this movie. Like, it was just an awesome experience. Like, maybe 5 days from now, I'll think, it wasn't that great. I don't think it would be as good on TV. I think you really have to be in that theater and you can't know what is going to happen next. And it is just, I think it's a rocking experience. It was great.
Call me a lightweight and say you get a buzz from one pale ale.
No comment.